Wednesday, April 26, 2017. For those of you who will be watching on TV, you can catch the agenda for this meeting by going to the website. Also, this meeting is going to be about a half hour, and then it will be followed by a meeting with our master plan subcommittee, and that, however, will not be televised, am I right?
Correct. Okay. It'll be recorded.
It'll be recorded, not live. So, my name is John Moyes, and to my left,
Jim Robinson.
Rachel McManus.
Elizabeth Mitchell.
Pete Pecos.
Martha Taylor, town planner.
So, we, in order of appearance, Adam True was to have appeared first.
George.
Yeah.
Excuse me. And not that I was purposely forgetting you, George.
Thank you, but George Morse is here too.
But George Morse is here too, and we have now permission from the Board of Selectmen that people can participate who are not here physically, and so I've received a note from George explaining that he has a physical ailment, and I've made the opinion that it's unreasonably difficult for him to participate, and so he can participate remotely. All votes taken during any meeting in which a member participates remotely shall be roll call vote. I think that's yours.
That's yours.
So, I think we're all set. So, Chris,
he's the boss.
You're the boss?
I guess so. I guess I'm the boss.
I said before, it's good to see you.
Good to see you. Good to be back. Steve Sorrow Design Consultants here on behalf of Chris Horn and what is it, Belmore Development. Has anyone seen the project has moved along quite rapidly?
Very good.
The septic is installed. Actually, I have the as-built to drop off. Mm-hmm. There was a change where Chris decided not to build the garages as part of the project. So what he's done, he's shifted this, instead of having this driveway come in and around, pulled the driveway closer for unit two. Unit one, the driveway is basically in the same location, where actually it's pulled closer also. If you look at the plan, you can see in the screen red is the proposed location of the garage, proposed contours. That was part of the original plan. The screened area is the actual as-built location of the driveways. So one, the garages were going to be directed to the cul-de-sacs, which at least, so that's there for the future if the garages, if the new homeowners want to build the garage. But the cul-de-sacs are still utilized by the, this portion of the roofs get directed to the cul-de-sacs. The original design, as far as stormwater, the water of the paved area just sheet flow over the grass, you get treatment through the grass, sheet flow over the grass, which has not changed. This is paved, you just have a longer run over grass.
So is there more pavement though?
Yeah, actually that's a key, that's the point is, got right to the point, we have a reduction of 244 square feet of pavement.
Okay.
Plus all of the garage. So there's a complete reduction of the garage and 244 square feet reduction of pavement. We had the original calculations took into account the walkways. They were called as peystone or brick. We weren't sure what we were going to build. They ended up brick, but the calculations included them as impervious. So the walkways were shortened also. The deduction of that is not included. The 244 deduction is just the paved driveway.
Okay.
So basically, it's an improvement. It's a reduction in impact as far as the paved area. I think what we'd like to do, I think we'd like to maintain the ability, I guess, in the future to construct per the original approved plan and not remove that. I think that's how we proceed. So if the homeowner, they wouldn't have to come in and re-permit it through the planning department, that okay, if they wanted to build it, they could pull, landscape this driveway and build it per the original plan.
I guess I just don't know, can we do that? We're now going back, we're going to approve it in a different way.
Right, so.
And then he has the right to go out and do what he was gonna do in that first place.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it would be up to the board. What they're doing right now is requesting a modification to the original.
Which is a less of an impact, and so we would allow him to go back and do something we had already approved.
Right, so the question would be, you know, whether you did want them to come before the board to at least tell us that that's gonna happen.
Maybe, you know, I don't know, since it was something we'd already approved, my instinct says, send a letter to Martha and let her know what you're doing.
Yeah, basically, it's what Steve said, it's, if someone decided to do the garage, it would have to revert back to the original plan you already approved. I think it's as simple as that.
Just let us know.
Yeah, we'd just like to know that it's happening, that they've chosen to do that.
Yeah, well, the situation now is we have buyers for all these. And
that's great.
It was, thank you. It's been great. It's mostly empty nesters, actually.
No kidding.
Yep. They loved it.
What's your price point?
$509 to $540.
The empty nesters from Newberry?
Middleton, Rowley, and what's the place? Local.
Very interesting.
Yeah. It was one which I was telling you, it was originally from Byfield. It's a mom and her teenage girl, so it's kind of nice.
That's nice.
But I sold those two units under the impression that they don't, both people that have bought those units right now do not have an intention of building a garage. But it's in the condo box that they can in the future. So that
so it may happen 10 years from now,
or may not
2 years
happen
from
at all.
Now. Or may not happen at
right.
all.
Yeah.
Depending on just how the project feels for everybody. I will say from an aesthetic point of view, I think it's better.
I don't think
it's less crowded.
I agree.
You know, when you said you were gonna do that, I went down and took a look and I said, yeah, it makes sense.
I like it much better the way I think you do too, Mark.
Yeah, I do.
I think
absolutely.
It's 100 times better about it.
Yeah.
And of course I've invested in this since I looked at it.
It's what you look at.
Yeah. So I'm thrilled that we're not doing it and I hope they don't do that.
Okay.
And really practically speaking, it's to build a 2-car garage is probably gonna be $50,000 to $60,000.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think the investment makes sense.
Yeah.
It's all about snow and
yeah.
nice, isn't it? I mean, it's.
Yeah.
Well, you're an empty nester. There's not that urgency to get out and go to work.
Right.
So you go to a little, like I said, car.
Right.
Not me.
But I did present them as if it is a possibility in the future, so I would like to preserve that as you were moving before.
Okay, so what do we have to do? What's
so,
the action actually that we need to take?
Well, the board needs to, if it chooses to approve this as a modification, first you need to determine whether it's a minor or major modification.
So, I'd like someone to give me something that says that it's a minor modification and then we can talk about it.
I move that the proposed changes to the plans for Balmoral Development presently before us amount to a minor modification.
Have a second.
Second.
Any discussion about it? Any further questions from anyone about what we see before us? Okay, so on that.
We need a roll call vote since George is participating remotely.
So I can't do all those in favor? You know, I don't think we've ever done a roll call. You're not voting, are you? Is Rachel voting?
No, no.
So it's Peter?
Yeah, Jim.
It's those four?
Yes, it's you four, plus
okay.
George.
Okay. George?
Yes.
How do you vote?
Minor.
Jim?
Minor.
Elizabeth?
Minor.
Peter?
Minor.
Myself, minor.
Okay, and then you need to actually vote to accept or approve the modification.
I so move to approve the minor modification just identified to the plans at 11 Central Street, redevelopment of the Methodist Church.
And a second?
Second.
Any further discussion of that? Or any questions? No? Then, Jim?
Yes, aye.
George?
No.
Okay.
So that means you approve?
That means you approve, right?
Oh, I do approve. I can barely hear you.
I'm sorry, sorry. You know, I'm going to turn this around so you can. Thanks, George.
Thanks.
Elizabeth?
Approve.
Peter?
Approve.
And John?
Approve.
Done.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thanks for all the help with the project.
Glad to hear that they're sold.
Yeah, so the move-ins are between May 15th and...
Oh, even better than I thought.
That's great.
Yeah.
For the summer?
Yeah, a couple moving in May 15th, June 1st, July 15th.
That's if ever gets a condo out there.
I'm on. I've already sold two and twice. Every time I call them, he says, call me next week. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks, Martin.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
We'll send you some later.
Oh, great. And then we should be all set. Yeah, okay. Thanks again, guys.
Okay, see ya. So, matter of 255, I wrote Adam Chase. And the tripartite agreement.
Oh, yeah.
We now have the...
Oh, there.
A clean copy.
Is this yours?
Three copies.
Oh, sorry, yeah. This I get the...
No.
I got the...
These three are notarized and signed by all parties except for you guys at this point. And we've got to fill in the front page, I assume, the booking pages to figure it out, right?
I think the issues that we had, have they been resolved? I got your memo, and what I wasn't clear on, relative to the schedule of work, and that, has that been increased from 66 to 87,000?
So the schedule of values here, did you get the email that I sent about the as-built plan? So I'm not seeing that here.
When was that?
It was sort of mid-afternoon, and I sent it to you.
I was going crazy to make this work.
I'm sure.
I mean, like, a little bit crazy.
So that was,
as-built is going to be part of Ed Dixon's DGT survey.
Okay.
So he's going to do stone bounds, road layout, and then as-built for all the houses and the road.
Okay.
But those are separate, he said, because they happen after, so.
Right, because that was the only comment that our engineer Joe had was that
just
he didn't see it on here, and then Scott Cameron emailed back and said that it would be 2,500, so we should add that to the schedule of values. So
okay.
That's not here. I don't know.
I mean, I wish Joe didn't wait till last.
Well, we didn't
3:30 today.
Well, we didn't get the schedule until this morning.
I know. I've been trying my hardest to keep on.
Answer me my first question, which was what you sent me was two schedules. One was 66.4,
right,
and one was 21.
Yeah. So what I thought was initially was just the road work itself, and all the auxiliary stuff is obviously. I have Ed Dixon DGT survey, my company, and TW Excavating, all in the chart.
Right, so that was, I sent that later in the day, as soon as we had everything except for the additional 2,500. So the total schedule of values now is this.
Oh, I don't know.
So the as-built are required anyways, though.
So what he's done now is he's itemized all the work that will be done by his company, by TW Excavating, and by
one does not have a schedule.
Oh.
One's for recording.
Okay.
Let me just.
I mean, sorry, one is for.
I can see yours.
One's not for recording. Only two, right?
Well, I asked for three, so that
we have three. Yes. One doesn't have a schedule.
Okay. Well, so we should have a schedule in all of the policies.
Small.
So the final amount, including 15% retainage, is $106,000. And I did have, Joe was comfortable with these numbers. I also had a kind of informal conversation with John O'Connell. He was very close to this number, as he said.
All right.
So I think that's fine. What I'm seeing here is knowing that Adam needs to do the as-built, it's a bare requirement anyway. I think that's probably okay. That number has not been filled in here on the first page of the tripartite agreement.
That was my question actually for you guys, is what number to fill in.
So
with the 15% retainage,
it would
be
this, it's 106, 345, 346, 25. so.
That was what I wasn't sure of, because, you know, it's asking how much the work costs, not necessarily the work plus the 15%, so I didn't know which one to put on.
Yeah, no, it's the.
Should be the higher number.
It's the highest number, because that represents the entire.
The entire amount that's being, okay.
Right, so.
So I'll fill that in.
And I know that your lender has signed it without that number filled in, so.
Yeah, they had the attached schedule, but they just didn't know when we were up in the air. They said, well, whatever one they pick.
So they're.
Yes, whatever one that they.
We can feel confident that they're okay with.
All right.
With either one. So.
Because they, you know, if it's higher than two.
So what we are missing is the $2,500 for the as-built.
For the as-built, that is a requirement for Adam to do that anyway, so.
I feel, in terms of that as a percentage of the total, I have comfort with that.
Yeah, and it brought it up to about $9,106, so it's not huge. You have to do it.
Remember what the guy said at town meeting? If that goes off, it's mine.
That's right.
Board members have any questions about the schedule, which was really the major issue that Martha and I had as of early last week? But do you have any other questions about the tripartite agreement?
No, I don't.
Do you as a neighbor have any questions?
No questions.
No, none? Okay.
I actually haven't looked at it, because I didn't have a comment on it.
Okay. Peter? So before we move forward on this, I did want to bring something up. And only because I received the copy of what Lauren sent to Martha last night. And it just seems that there's obviously some issues going on.
Right.
And what I go back to the agreement that we have for the subdivision approval, and although it has nothing to do with what's going on now,
yeah,
we do, there's two things that you're to be doing. Prior to the start of construction, you're supposed to have a meeting with the town planner, highway engineer, and the board's consultant. Has that happened?
Not yet, because the plans haven't, you know, we're just endorsing the plans.
So let's assume that happens. And then, you know, as part of what we're talking about, and it was only really to do with screening, it says the applicant will make all reasonable efforts to work and cooperate with the abutters to provide adequate visual screening. Admittedly, that's something that's down the line, but I'm concerned about what, when I see something what Laurel Warren sent, and because.
I don't know that I've seen it, but.
Well, it was, I don't.
We're a little taken back by Ms. Mitchell. I've received an email from her that seemed a little out of place, and I received a text message, which I ignored, because we're not doing anything out of line, and Sam Johnson's already been out to the site to check to that extent. So at this point, it feels like harassment. I'll be straightforward. And with you, Elizabeth, it feels like harassment. And I'd ask you to stop. We're not doing anything outside of our parameters. We're clearing a lot. We're chipping. I don't know what to say. If you can't work at home because it's too loud, and you want to get upset at us and send me emails,
let me.
My wife's gonna respond back. How does that come?
Can I just proceed for 1 second? Is that I'm happy to share the notes that I sent to Adam, but I certainly
you've also
not
called me a liar in public.
Actually, I think it was you. They called me a liar.
We sorted that out either way.
But. Adam, let me just tell you that I did not intend to harass you, and I frankly.
I would just ask that I'll contact you.
Excuse
when
me.
Time's
could
ready.
You?
That's all.
No, that doesn't. It's not a one-way street, Adam.
I'm sorry.
Is that I'm your neighbor, and I asked a question. I asked you a question, and I'm entitled to ask you a question as a neighbor, and
but
I asked.
But when you've been a rude neighbor, I'm less inclined to answer you. I've already met with the Kennedys about this screening, and when I get to my driveway in your part, I will meet with you.
I didn't ask about the screening, Adam. I asked about the placement of the driveway because I wanted to understand.
I don't know what you mean by placement of the driveway.
Well, right
there's
now.
There's no driveway that I saw.
Right,
I was driving through a field.
Right now, what I'm seeing is you driving in an area that was not the approved placement.
It's
and
my property, my field.
Adam,
I'm just driving on.
Would you like to
cut a driveway, apparently.
To what I'm asking.
I don't want to listen. I'm sorry.
Okay. So for the board's application.
So maybe we don't want to sign the agreement.
Nope. Be that then. I guess if that's what's going to hold it up, because I feel like it's unreasonable on her end of what she's asking and how she's approaching.
I don't mind telling you that, you know, I live only about 500 to 600 feet from where you were working. And I was tremendously disturbed by the work that you were doing there.
The chipping? What else am I supposed to do?
You don't have to chip there.
Oh, so for everybody around, I should not chip on site?
The other thing you could do is that, as most developers do, go and meet with the butters and explain what you're doing.
I did explain everything to every butter.
I didn't get anything.
I didn't know that you abutted. And I don't know that I have to even do that. I'm just trying to clear the lot.
You know what it is?
It's a respect thing, yes.
It's a respect thing. And it's a way.
Well, if I had felt respect for Miss Mitchell, I would have called. But I don't feel respect. I feel a lack of respect. I feel trees planted on my property, which everybody clearly saw when we walked up there. Okay, and I would love to put a fence up that line at this point to make a good neighbor. You know, I'm really at odds right now. And if I have to get my lawyer involved, I will. I literally will. I'm at my end. You know, I've worked so hard on this thing, and for one person to railroad the whole way through, and I get everything done, and I work hard, but she can have her way. And it doesn't make no sense to me.
Mr. Chairman?
Yeah.
So I think the important thing here is to try to de-escalate what's going on right now, because it's not going in a positive direction. You want to get your project done. Yes, it's your land, and everybody understands that. It's just good communication without conflict. And right now it's bumpy. I think you have to get past the bumps so everybody's comfortable. And so I think less defense and more listening and just sitting back is helpful. We don't need North Korea and South Korea. That's not productive. So I'd encourage you to make it work. You don't need to get a lawyer involved here. It's just communication.
If I have to, though, I don't know what to say, because I feel like everything I do is being watched. Sam Jocelyn's already been up to the site per order of Elizabeth. Check it out.
That's not accurate.
You know, he came out. He told me that you called him. Am I missing something?
I called him.
No? Okay.
I wrote you a note, and I asked you if you could get back to me as to where your intended placement of the driveway was.
It's exactly as intended on these miners.
And I also asked you if you could let me know what your plan was for chipping. And I asked you to get back to me in my second note, and I said if I didn't hear from you, I would reach out to Sam to see if he knew anything. I left Sam a telephone message. I never heard back from Sam, so I did not know the result of that meeting.
He called me, he went to the site, and he said everything's in orderly condition, there's nothing you're doing wrong, there's no quiet hours in Newbury. And everything that was happening during regular business hours anyways. I said yes.
Adam, I'm not trying, you have...
I mean, regular business hours, we're trying to clear a house lot, it's done.
Adam, would you let me speak for just a minute? Because I think if you do, then that might help things. But I'm not challenging you, I'm not trying to obstruct you. I live there. The driveway, where you're driving now, is not where the approved plans were. I just wanted to know if we were on the same page as to where the driveway was going to end up. I think Lauren answered the question, and I appreciate that. I also was asking about the chipping, because it is loud and invasive, and I understand that you need to do what you need to do, but there are a tremendous amount of trees there, and now you've been moving them off site, which is great. And so I think I just wanted to know what the plan was. If you were going to chip all those trees there, that could have taken months. And so I think it's just really helpful for us to understand what you're doing, because when we don't have that information, it's stressful. If I knew you were going to be out there for 2 weeks and then you were, you know, do whatever portion of work you were going to do, that's really helpful for us to understand and appreciate how long the noise is going to last.
Sure.
I can live with 2 weeks. I can live with the construction of the house. Again, as John said, the chipping was particularly loud and invasive. I get it. You need to build your property. But I agree with what Peter is saying and what John is saying, is if we can have open lines of communication, that would be fantastic. And I don't think that ignoring me, and I apologize if my notes to you seemed like harassment. They're not intended to be. I think that the more that we can communicate, hopefully the better the lines of communication will be. And
sure,
rather than assuming the worst, maybe we can have a positive working relationship. You're building a house, and I think you have a lovely, lovely spot. You've already articulated that you chose to live there for the very same reasons that we chose to live there.
Yeah.
And I, you know, as a neighbor, I welcome you to that area. And I think that together we can work to have something that's really wonderful for both our families. So I'm not trying to stop you.
Believe
I'm
me,
not.
I'm the last person in the world who wants to be like this. When I'm a developer, people come at me all the time.
And I can understand that
a
perspective.
A lot of it's like, you know, I'm sorry.
But
you put developer on my forehead and everybody hates me also.
I don't hate you.
It's a real thing. We can all agree.
I don't
you know.
Hate you,
well,
but I would like
nobody
to...
likes change. I get it.
No, it's not change. It's, I think, just so you're aware, I think that you knew that the driveway was a big deal to us. So
but I
when,
didn't put any driveway in,
okay,
so I don't feel like I have to call when I'm just driving.
Okay, you know, we have to move
yeah,
on because we have another meeting that we're going to start in 2 minutes. My point in bringing this up was to see if you two, both of you, can somehow work together in a collaborative way so that these things don't occur. And that when you get to the point when you're building your driveway, that you can come up with a solution that we did require that you work positively with both Mr. Kennedy and the Mitchells to come up with a solution that works. That's all right. Okay. So with that, I'm happy to sign this with the idea that you will be working cooperatively with both. Now what do I sign?
Well, there. So the number does need to be put in, which is the 106-346-25. George is going to have to sign this. He's ill tonight, so he's not here. We also have to get it notarized.
Okay.
So we can't give it back to you tonight.
Yeah, sure. You want me to fill in the 106 part? At least.
Yeah, it would probably be good if you were to do that. I have three copies.
106.
What motion do we need on this?
So I think that the motion would be to approve and vote to execute the tripartite agreement.
No, this one. Okay, while we're waiting for this, can I have a motion to that effect?
Sure. I move that we agree to the tripartite agreement, and do we also need to approve our signatures?
Can you hear that, George?
I would say vote to execute.
As well as to vote to execute.
Yes, I can.
Okay, good. You have a second on that?
Okay.
Any further discussion on the tripartite agreement? Hearing none, do I have to poll this too?
Yes.
Peter?
Yes.
Myself, yes?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, that's it.
Okay.
Right.
And I did confirm with town council that even though Pete wasn't involved in the definitive plan decision, he can vote on this. There's some question
okay.
about whether he can endorse the drawing, so we'll need to have
okay.
Jim. The other thing that we'll need to get is a motion. Since the agreement needs to be notarized, we need a motion for John to go before the, or one of you to go before the town clerk to confirm that this was all done of your own free will. Rather than having all of you do that.
Okay. Now this is an old one. This is a current one. How many? Now I'm a little confused because I have one. I've got one here.
And here's one that has the
schedule. Yeah, there's one.
And here. This one doesn't have the schedule.
And we need to make sure.
I need one back. One would stay with the town.
Right.
And then one goes to get recorded with the registrars. And this copy is for you guys, right? The town mylars with the.
Yeah, you'll take
Merrimack Valleys.
Right, you'll actually take one set of mylars to be recorded at the registry.
This one, the registry.
Right, and
About the two thumb drives, did one go to the registry?
No, that, those come to me.
You'll date this and everything, Martha?
Yes.
This one does not have a schedule.
Okay.
George, are you able to come by tomorrow or the next day?
No, I'll be there tomorrow by noon.
Okay, good.
Before.
Okay. And then the plans?
And we need the board to make the motion to authorize John to have the signatures notarized.
I would move that we allow John Weiss to have the signatures notarized.
I'm sorry, just a, let's see.
Leslie,
okay. Can I have a second on that?
Second.
All those in favor? George?
Aye.
Okay, so it's 4-0.
Let's see, there's one more.
You've got...
I've got two.
I don't, do you have a third copy down there?
What's that?
No, just go down that way.
Or is that?
Yeah, this has got the schedule.
So we need one more schedule?
You need another schedule.
So I drop that in tomorrow, staple to it? Can you guys print one out?
I can print one out.
Okay.
And then what about the plans?
So then the board needs to vote to endorse the plans. And I think that will just be you, George, and Jim.
Yeah.
Because you haven't been here.
Yeah.
Okay, so here are the three tripartite agreements. And then can I have a motion from either George or Jim to endorse the plans that submitted? What's the date of these?
Should be today's date.
Is it today's date?
So the dates are...
Well, we can...
So we do, we change that, so I think we change that from here, the endorsement, but the plan itself is dated February 8th.
February 8th.
February...
Well, February, the last date on the plan is February 8th.
2017, that might have been right around, this was the last date of approval, our date of approval is January 18th.
Right, it was amended after approval, so it's February to February 8th is the last.
That's probably the most recent one then.
Right, and then we'll just change that to, yeah, for endorsement, so we'll just change that to today's date.
So endorse and approve, endorse and approve, or just endorse?
Approve and endorse.
So what date now?
Today's February 24th.
No, plans dated February 8th.
February 8th.
Okay.
The last revision revised to February.
Okay, so I move that the board endorse and accept the plan, approve the plan dated 26 April 2017.
Well, it's...
April.
Revised through February 8th.
Through February 8th, should I do that again?
Revised through February 8th, but dated today, is that right?
Well, the date of endorsement is today.
Date of endorsement is today, okay.
Which is the last date of change.
George, you get that?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Any, you need to second it, George.
Second.
Okay. Any further discussion on it? All those in favor?
Roll call.
Aye.
Oh, roll call, George? Aye. Jim?
Aye.
John, aye, okay.
These things look expensive.
And do we need to sign this now?
So it will need to be signed, we could do it after.
Let's do it afterwards, let's do it afterwards. Just leave them with us and we'll sign them.
Okay, so then the registry copy, does that have to stay with you guys to be signed?
Well, the copy that goes to the registry...
Would be signed.
Would be signed.
So I'm gonna leave both copies in?
Yes.
These are, I think, just my regular copies.
Okay, and what we'll want is copies back with recording on this side.
Yeah, I think he said maybe this one would be coming back to you guys, or this one
we'll start the registry.
Stays the registry.
And then we'll need prints as well.
Yep.
Okay, and these are the two thumb drives with the AutoCAD.
Two thumb drives and then one set of prints, two or more?
Five sets of prints to come back to us.
Five sets of prints to come back after they're done?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you, guys.
Adam, we
are... I'm sure in the end everybody will be happy.
We are excited to have you get started. So when do you think you will start?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
I don't know.
So do you build your house first or the spec house?
I'm gonna start with the road and then road to the circle and the spec house. And start revamping the barn a little bit too, so...
So you do most of your work upfront first and you'll build your house in the fall?
Not until the fall, yeah.
Good luck.
All right, thanks a lot.
All right, bye-bye.
Adam, I'd like to reach out to you and Warren separately and maybe we can get together and...
Sure, yeah, I'd like that.
I think things can be good.
All right, reach out, we'll get together.
Okay.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Do you have a question for Martha?
Yeah.
Yeah, has the pre-construction conference been scheduled?
No, it hasn't because the plans haven't been endorsed yet. So once, you know, once they're endorsed and recorded, he's actually starting, then we'll schedule that. So I'll reach out to him in the next day or so and see if we can get that set up.
Okay. I think we can not go forward on these other things. Let's get these guys in here.
Okay, so you want to adjourn?
Yeah, let's adjourn the meeting. We can come back to these liaison reports later.
Or do it next
we'll
time.
Get the master plan committee. We could do it next time. Okay. There's no
nothing, there's nothing huge.
I have stuff I can tell you from MVPC, but there's some very creative stuff that's going on there, and maybe I'll have a presentation that I could make when we have a little slower time to show you, because the stuff that they've done is kind of interesting in terms of the new website and the annual report. Have you seen that?
No, I haven't.
That's really good. It's really good. Anyway, should I'll look at you.
Okay, motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.